Hello everyone. Today, we will present to you about biological hazard. This video consists of the definition, types, mode of transmission, levels, and countermeasures related to biological hazard. Did you know what is the definition of biological hazard? It is an organisms or products of organisms that present a health hazard to humans. This hazard can be encountered anywhere in the environment, whether at home, office, or supermarket. This hazard can cause a variety of health effects to humans, ranging from cancer, skin irritation, and allergies to infection, such as TB and AIDS.
There are three types of biological hazard. The first one is the infectious agents. Infectious agents consist of three types, which is bacteria, virus, and fungi. Bacteria is a microscopic organism that lives in soil, water, organic matter, or the bodies of plants and animals. While virus is a group of pathogens which is totally dependent on their host for replication. Last one is a fungi. It is usually a group of lower plants that lack of chlorophyll and live on dead or other living organism. Second type of biological hazard is caused by certain plants such as mold and yeast, which is also classified as fungi. If we get contact with this kind of hazard, it will cause us diseases such as irritant contact and allergies. Last type of the biological hazard is caused by animal and animal product. Animals sometimes may carry harmful germs that can spread to people and cause illness. This kind of illness is known as zoonosis. Generally, animals that consist of toxin inside their body such as scorpion, jellyfish and snake is also included as biological hazard. So these are the example of occupational group that will have a direct contact to the biological hazard. Medical lab technician, farm worker, diver, and also the forestry worker.
There are two modes of transmission. The first one is direct human-to-human infection. This mode requires physical contact between infected person and susceptible person. The second mode is indirect transmission, which has four types. The first type is through surface contact. This is because some infectious agents can survive on surfaces for extended periods of time. The second type is foodborne or waterborne toxins. This infectious, usually the result of contaminations of food through poor food hygiene. The third type is droplet or airborne contamination. This condition can occur from human or environmental sources, as droplets can travel up to a meter in the air and can enter the respiratory tract. The last type is vector-borne diseases. A vector is an organism that carries disease-causing microorganisms from one host to another.
Now, I'm going to explain a bit regarding level of biological hazard. A biosafety level, BSL, or pathogen protection level, which are ranked from 1 to 4, are selected based on the severity of agents or organisms. For example, for non-lethal agents that pose a minimal potential threat are considered as BSL-1, which is the lowest biosafety level. The potential deadly infectious agents like Ebola will be designated as BSL-4, which is the highest level. For BSL-1, it is usually organisms that are relatively harmless to a human. So, the best way to prevent people from this bacteria is wearing PPE, such as gloves or face masks. Washing hands also one of the most important things to prevent bad organisms to enter your body. Example of disease for BSL-1 include hepatitis, chickenpox, and E. coli. Next, for BSL-2, it is usually bacteria or virus that can cause mild symptoms. How to prevent it? Basically a bit same with BSL-1, but with add-on eye protection and face shield. Example of disease for BSL-2 include salmonella, measles, Lyme disease, influenza, as known as common cold, and HIV. For BSL-3, this type of organism can cause severe or even fatal symptoms, but it can be treated by vaccines or other treatment that known exist. More protective primary barriers are used, such as solid foam wrap around gowns, scrub suits or coveralls, and respirators. If they are not contained properly, an outbreak could occur and potentially harm thousands of people. Example of disease for BSL-3 is anthrax, malaria, tuberculosis, and typhus. The last one, which is BSL-4. This is the worst level since it can cause severe illness or death, and there is no treatment available. Airflow of the room is tightly controlled. Air always flow into the isolation room, but not escape from the room, which called negative pressure room. The personnel also need to wear air supplied full body suit. Example of disease for BSL-4 include Ebola, bird flu, Bolivian, and also dengue fever.
Next, I will continue with a countermeasure to mitigate the hazard. There are several countermeasures to mitigate the biological hazard. The first one is engineering control, for example, is ventilation system, and the second one is administrative control, and the third one is personal protective equipment, or we call as PPE. Several characterization of PPE, such as respiratory protection. For example, is surgical mask. Surgical mask consists of 3 layers of non-woven fabric, and the next one is N series, R series, or P series. Next is protective clothing, which is to protect the body from the contamination. The example for protective clothing is hazmat suit, with using glove and shoes cover. Next is goggles or face shield. For example, are glass without side shield goggles. This one is for protect our eyes, and the next one is face shield to protect our face from the liquid splash. The next one is biological waste. Biological waste is contaminated PPE disposed in special design rubbish bag with biological hazard universal label. The last one is sterilization. Sterilization is disinfecting the contaminated premises and through cleaning of any residual toxic substance. The common sterilization example are liquid bleach or rubbing alcohol.
And that is all for this video. Hope you guys enjoy and learn something about biological hazard. Bye and have a good day.